October 28th, 1977. Dear colleagues, I'm presently flying over Greenland on my return from Tbilisi, USSR, as a member of the United States delegation to the World Conference on Environmental Education, October 14th through 26th. I thought that this might be the best time to draft some of my comments before reaching Ann Arbor and trying to get caught up from 3 weeks abroad. Realizing your interest in this international movement in environmental education, I've tried to capture some of the highlights based on my observations as the former director of UNESCO's Environmental Education Program, a member of the United States delegation to the Tbilisi Conference, and as a vice president of the conference. The conference was held in Tbilisi, USSR, because the USSR had expressed a deep interest in a world conference on environmental education in their country. The Soviet authorities decided to hold the meeting in Tbilisi, the capital of the Georgian Republic, close to the Caspian Sea. Tbilisi is a lovely city of around 1 million people nestled in a valley surrounded by mountains. The people were very friendly, and the entire city went all out to show us a delightful time. The conference center was in the Supreme Soviet Building. Serving as one of the vice presidents of the meeting made life extra interesting, but extremely busy. In addition to the regular sessions, 10 to 1 and 3 to 6, I needed to attend regular meetings in the early morning and in the evening and during crisis situations. I also attended specific strategy sessions with the United States delegation every day, and special meetings on specific topics that resulted from the general sessions. A typical day went from 6 a.m. to around 2 or 3 in the morning throughout the two-week period. The food was typically Georgian, lots of sausage, cheese, magnificent bread, soups, fruit, lamb, salads, yogurt, rice, and lots of white wine. There were several receptions held during the conference, and as you might imagine, the layout was magnificent, and the wine, vodka, and cognac flowed. As for cultural activities, I was most impressed with the native folk dancers, ballet, hiking in the old parts of the city, and mixing with the Georgian people. Such a rich culture. Even though Stalin came from Tbilisi, I only saw one picture of him. Every government room and most other rooms had a picture or statue of Lenin. With the 60th anniversary of the October Revolution being celebrated, there were many posters of the philosophy of the revolution. The overall representation of the conference was excellent, considering that this was the first intergovernmental conference on environmental education to be held. In total, there were official delegations from approximately 70 countries, 15 from Africa, 9 Arab states, 29 from Europe, and 8 from Latin America, representing all of the developed countries and around half of the developing countries. 8 organizations of the United Nations, 3 other intergovernmental organizations, and 20 international non-governmental organizations. As for total participants, there were over 265 delegates and an additional 65 representatives and observers. In general, the preparation of the delegates for the conference was excellent. The conference adopted an international framework of environmental education. This consisted of a good statement, objectives, guiding principles, and targeted audiences for environmental education. The conference adopted 16 national, 17 regional and international, and 5 miscellaneous recommendations, totaling 38. There was a remarkable amount of agreement at the conference, at both the conceptual and strategy levels, between the Eastern and Western European countries and the developing countries, Africa, Arab states, Asia, and Latin America. The participants focused on substantive issues of environmental education, rather than pure political rhetoric. The focus of the conference was always on the issues to be discussed. There was an adoption of a strong conference report, and the commitment of delegations to work with their governments in implementing the recommendations.